So in order for cells to maintain homeostasis, they do need to move things in and out of the cells. And there's a couple different ways that they transport things. There's passive transport and active transport. The first kind of passive transport is diffusion. And diffusion is simply the movement of molecules from an area of higher concentration to an area of lower concentration. And that's what this little picture is showing. Let's say I drop a cube of sugar into some water. That sugar is going to dissolve. The water molecules are polar. They're going to bump into the sugar molecules and break them apart. Nature wants to spread out, and so those sugar molecules are going to spread out. This does not require any energy. And in cells, diffusion works really well with small molecules like carbon dioxide, water, and oxygen, because these molecules are so small that they can fit between the phospholipids. So they don't need to use embedded proteins. These are like the golf balls that can easily move through a volleyball net. So here, diffusion, we have simple, very small molecules that can fit in the spaces in between. Another form of passive transport, passive meaning we don't need any energy, is facilitated diffusion. And facilitated diffusion is diffusion through an embedded protein. It's diffusion where you just need a little bit of help. And we need to use this for molecules that are too big to fit between the phospholipids, so we actually need to create a doorway or a channel. Glucose, amino acids, they're going to be bigger, and so they need to move through a channel. You can also have very small molecules that could physically fit, but they have a charge. Magnesium, chloride, these can interact with the heads of the phospholipids, but when they move down by the tails, they're going to get pushed back because remember, those tails are nonpolar and they don't want to interact with anything that has a charge. So the embedded proteins are going to create a safe passage for charged molecules or ions to move through the cell membrane. There are different kinds of channels. Here you can see this one opens up and molecules can flow right through. Other kinds will open on one side, pick up a series of molecules, then open up on the other side and dump them out. Either way, neither of these require energy. We have a higher concentration outside the cell, lower concentration inside, and so they easily move through the embedded proteins. And this is all kinds of diffusion. A different kind of movement is active transport. And this is when we move molecules from an area of low concentration to an area of high concentration. So now we're moving molecules against the concentration gradient. Think of this as moving something uphill instead of downhill. It's the opposite of diffusion, and this is going to require energy in the form of ATP. This is also going to use embedded proteins, but a different set of embedded proteins. And there's various examples of active transport proteins in cells. Plants especially use something called sodium pumps, and animals use hydrogen pumps. So here you can imagine you have lots of hydrogen ions, and you want to pump even more hydrogen ions to the area of high concentration. You're going to use active transport. So here this picture is showing the diamonds. We have only a few on the outside of the cell. We have more inside the cell, but we want to continue to move more and more of these inside. We're going to have to use a different protein and add energy to that to do active transport. Osmosis is a very specialized kind of diffusion. So it's the diffusion of water in the presence of a semi-permeable membrane. So remember, diffusion just means moving from a higher concentration to a lower concentration. So here is an example. We've got a beaker. It's got a semi-permeable membrane. This would be similar to a cell membrane. On one side, we have solution that's 10% sugar, and on the other side, 20% sugar. So, if you were to calculate the concentration of water on this side, if this is 10% sugar, it must be 90% water. And on this side, if it's 20% sugar, it must be 80% water. So now we can figure out diffusion is the movement of water from high concentration to low concentration. We have 90% water on this side, 80% water on this side, and so the water's going to flow from the right to the left, and the water level is actually going to move up. Now, normally we have a high concentration of sugar, and by basic diffusion, the sugar would want to move to this side of the beaker. But here's the problem. The semipermeable membrane allows water to move through, but not the sugars. It blocks the sugars. So only when that membrane is present do we block the movement of the sugars, and then the result is the movement of water, which is osmosis. And this video will give you a visual of what I just explained.